What is up, everybody? My name is iRocky, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make the best James Harden build in NBA 2K20. I've been ballin' so damn hard, I swear I think that I'm Kobe. Young bull on this rap shit, but I think that I'm Kobe. I swear I'm dunking on these hoes, on these niggas I'm free throwing. These boys, they don't like me cause I think that I'm Kobe. So in order to make this James Harden build, you're going to have to make him a shooting guard, and the handedness and jersey number does not matter, but since it is James Harden, he is left-handed, so I made it left-handed just for fun, and he's number 13, so I made him number 13 just for fun as well. And going into the skill breakdown, you're going to want to choose the second pie chart, the finishing and shooting pie chart. And for physicals, you're going to want to choose the pure agility pie chart to get that 85 speed, and you still have a pretty good vertical for a shooting guard. And first off, you're going to want to max out close shot, driving layup, driving dunk, and then put standing dunk at a 42 to get 15 finishing badges. Then moving down to shooting, max out every single thing in the shooting section to get 21 shooting badges. And then playmaking, max out pass accuracy, ball handle, and then we'll come back to that later, but now we're going to focus on defense and rebounding, where we're going to max out perimeter defense, lateral quickness, steal, and defensive rebound. And now with the before we go back, make the offensive rebounds up to a 34, so you get 6 defensive and rebounding badges, and then put the remainder on post moves, so you get that boost to playmaking badges. And so this is the build overview. As you can see, it's pretty good at everything. You know, the defense could be a little bit better, but James Harden is not known to be the best defender in the NBA. And then you know, all of his offensive stats are very balanced, and it's just a very good overall build. Body shape does not matter. I make all my builds defined, and then keep him at 6'5", so it's like the real Harden, and his physicals and stats don't go down. So yeah, just keep him at 6'5". You could make him lowest weight to get the +3 lateral quickness, and then the boost in acceleration and vertical, or you could make him more accurate to his actual weight, which is around like 200, but I went with lowest weight, which is 175. And then for wingspan, it might sound surprising, but you don't want to make him have this small wingspan. You want to have him at 78.0 wingspan, so that you get the 83 mid-range and 81 ball handle. And in order to make this similar to James Harden, you need to have this wingspan, or else James Harden will not show up as the similar players. So then after that, I prefer shot creator takeover on this build, but all of these takeovers are obviously very good options. But yeah, for this build, I chose shot creator. And as you can see, offensive threat similar to Mitch Richmond, James Harden, and Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. And now I'm going to show you the best badges for this build. So as you can see, you have a very balanced badge spread on this build: 15 finishing, 21 shooting, 14 playmaking, and 6 defensive and rebounding. So first, for your finishing, obviously max out contact finisher to Hall of Fame, Hall of Fame slithery finisher, Hall of Fame fancy footwork, and then with the remaining 3, you could really put it anywhere. You could put, say, Bronze Lob City, Bronze Acrobat, and Bronze Giant Slayer, or no, you wouldn't really want to be catching lobs on this build. It is a shooting guard. So what I would do is put Giant Slayer or Acrobat on silver. It doesn't really matter. But those are the finishing badges. And then moving on to shooting, 21. This is a very good shooting build. And I would max out Quick Draw, Range Extender, Green Machine, Deadeye. And then with the remaining 5, I would put Difficult Shots on Hall of Fame. And then you could really put this one upgrade anywhere. I chose to put it on either Volume Shooter, Hot Zone Hunter, or Catch and Shoot, but I'm going to put it on Hot Zone Hunter. If you have Hot Zones in the park, that's what I would recommend. If not, I would put it on, probably on Catch and Shoot. And then moving over to playmaking, it's not Hall of Fame, but you do have 14 potential upgrades. So let's go to handles for days, max that out, quick first step, max that out, space creator, max that out, tight handles, max that out, and then put unpluggable on silver. And then moving on to defensive and rebounding, you could do a lot of things here. You could put clamps on gold and intimidator on gold, or you could put clamps and intimidator on silver, and then put pickpocket, or even pick dodger, or interceptor. But what I would prefer is to have intimidator and clamps on gold. And yeah, that's the build. As you can see from the attributes and the badges, it's very balanced offensively and defensively. Don't let the 6 defensive and rebounding scare you, because as a shooting guard, you really only need intimidator and clamps, because you're not going to be setting screens or protecting the paint. So yeah, there's the build. I'm doing a 10 log giveaway at 100 subscribers, so if you would please help me get there, I'd really appreciate it. If you found this video entertaining or helpful, please drop a like, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.